Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. All right, we're going to solve this trig problem. Use a half-angle identity to find the exact value of sine of 157.5 degrees and tangent of 157.5 degrees. So, in half an angle identity, the hint is this is half of some special angle, hopefully. So let's check out. What is twice that? Just use a calculator, but I don't have one handy. So let's see, that would be 0, 15, 11, 315 degrees. And yes, 315 degrees is one of your special angles. It's in quadrant 3 over here. Or that's the 45 degree angle right here. So that is 315 degrees. Now we are not finding the sine or tangent of 315 degrees, but it'll be useful to know the sine, cosine, and tangent of 315 degrees in our half angle formulas. Let's just go ahead and put our values on here. This would be 1, the y value here would be negative 1, and that's square root of 2. That's our 315 degrees. Just keep that in mind. All right, so let's first do the sine of 157.5 degrees. So you could say, well, that's really the same thing as the sine of 315 degrees divided by 2. And so now we could use our half angle formula. And the half angle formula, the identity is that it will be plus or minus. Well, this is a little bit tricky here. Wait a minute. Is it going to be plus or is it going to be minus? Remember, normally you would write plus or minus, and for sine it's 1 minus cosine of A. But in this case, your A is your 315 degrees. It's the numerator over 2. We have to decide whether we're going to use the plus or the minus sign. Well, what are we doing? We're taking the sine of 157.5 degrees. What quadrant is that in? That's in quadrant 2. And in quadrant 2, is the sine positive or negative? It's positive. The y value is positive in quadrant 2. So this will just be plus. You don't have to write a plus, you could just leave it off, right? Okay, so we need to know the cosine of 315 degrees. Well, that's why I drew this little picture, so we could see it easily. Or some of you have memorized it, possibly. I don't memorize it. So I have 1 minus. Now, what's the cosine of 315 degrees? That would be 1 over square roots of 2, or square roots of 2 over 2. I'm going to write it that way. Square roots of 2 over 2, all over 2. And now we have, once again, this messy complex fraction, which we can deal with in more than one way. I do it by multiplying numerator and denominator by the least common denominator. So that gives me 'll have a plus sign there, which you could write or leave off. If it's a minus sign, don't forget to keep writing the minus sign. 1 times 2 is 2 minus. Now, square roots of 2 over 2 times 2, the 2's cancel. That's why we did that. And in the denominator, we have 2 times 2 is 4, which is nice because now it's going to be easy to rationalize the denominator since square root of 4 is a perfect square. So our answer here is, do I have any more room? Sorry, there we go. Is going to be the square root of the top all over 2. And that is our answer for the sine of 100, 200, what was it? 157.5 0.5 degrees equals that mass. Okay, so we did half the problem. Now we need to find out the tangent of 157.5 degrees. So let's start that. All right, part two, find the tangent of 157.5 degrees. Again, we're going to use a half angle identity. So this is going to be the same thing as, actually I'll write it out. The tangent of 157.5 degrees is the same thing as the tangent of 315 degrees over 2. So I could use one of the half angle identities. There are three half angle identities. One of them, you've got the square roots and you have to decide whether it's positive or negative, which isn't so bad because the tangent of 157.5, well, we know that 157.5 is in quadrant 2, where x is negative and y is positive. So it's going to be negative. Our answer will be negative. Okay, so you can keep that in note. The tangent of 157.5 degrees will be negative. So because we know it's in tangent, I mean, since 157.5 degrees is in quad 2. Okay, but we've got three formulas you could choose from. And here are the formulas. All right, first formula, you have plus or minus square root of 1 minus cosine. Well, if I'm using u instead of x or a, it's 1 minus cosine u over 1 plus cosine u. So you would have the square roots in it. But here's this other formula. We could do sine u over 1 plus cosine u, or we could do 1 minus cosine u over sine u. It's up to you which one of these you want to use. I think it's easier to use the second or the third formula. So let's go ahead with the third formula. All right, so here's the third formula. And in our case, A is 315 degrees. So we're going to just plug that in. The tangent of 315 degrees over 2 equals 1 minus the cosine of 315 degrees over the sine of 315 degrees. Okay, let's look at our little picture over here to the right, where I have the picture for 315 degrees. The cosine of 315, that's the one that's positive. 1 over square roots of 2, or square roots of 2 over 2. And the sine is going to be negative, right? Negative 1 over square roots of 2, which is just negative square roots of 2 over 2. And again, I've got a complex fraction, but at least no radicals. So let's multiply by the least common denominator. 2 times 1 is 2 minus, now, these 2's will cancel when I multiply it, so I just get minus square roots of 2. And in the denominator, the 2's will cancel, and I have negative the square roots of 2. So I do still have a square root here. So I'd like to get rid of the square root. So I can multiply by the square root of 2. I think I'll get rid of that minus sign, too. I kind of like it when there's no negative numbers in the denominator. So I'm going to multiply the numerator and denominator by negative square roots of 2. That'll rationalize the denominator, and it will also put a positive number in the denominator. So if I do the distributive property here, first I'm going to distribute the second one. So I have negative square roots of 2 times negative square roots of 2. That'll be a positive 2, right? And then when I multiply it by the first term, that'll be minus 2 square roots of 2. And in the denominator, I've got just a negative times a negative is a positive, and a square root of 2 times square root of 2 is 2. Oh, and then I have to factor the numerator, because I could take out a common factor of 2. 1 minus square root of 2 all over 2. Let's cancel. And my final answer is 1 minus square roots of 2. Now, remember that we said that the tangent of 157.5 degrees should come out negative. Well, square root of 2 is approximately 1.4, so this is a negative number. So this is the exact value of 315. The exact value for 157.5 degrees is 1 minus square root of 2. And so here are our two answers. These are the exact values. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.